Tomi Ungerer was born the youngest of four children into a middle-class family in the eastern French city of Strasbourg in 1931. His father died unexpectedly in 1935 when Tomi was only 4 years old, and his mother subsequently took her children to live in the town of Logelbach, which was also close to the border with Germany. Only a few years later, in 1939, the Second World War began, and the Germans occupied the Alsace region in 1940. At school, Tomi was not a model student, with little interest in anything other than drawing, including some early cartoons mocking the Germans, and his headmaster described him in a school report as a perverse and subversive individual, which turned out to be a fairly accurate prediction of Ungerer's later approach to image-making. He was 13 in the winter of 1944 when the region was liberated by the Allies and the Germans were forced to retreat. When he finished school, he spent several aimless years involving casual labour, a year in the French army, and an equally brief spell at the School of Decorative Arts in Strasbourg. But during this time he'd continued to draw, and armed with a portfolio of his accumulated images, he set off for America in 1956. Amazingly, within a year, his first children's book, The Mellops Go Flying, was published, and it was an immediate widespread success, which was loved by children and admired by critics, and its popularity led to several more about this family of pigs, up to 1963. In a burst of remarkable creative energy, Ungerer produced other similarly endearing animal-themed books in rapid succession, including 1958's story of Crictor, about a snake who makes himself useful to his schoolteacher owner and other humans. And this was followed in 1960 by the equally engaging and inventive story of Emile, an octopus who has similar positive encounters. Both these books sold in healthy numbers and, like his ongoing Mellops series, forged a strong reputation for both his writing and his illustration. Ungerer's scribbled spidery line and cavalier approach to anatomy was certainly distinctive in the children's picture book market at the time, but it did owe a stylistic debt to Saul Steinberg and André François, both of whom were 20 years his senior. But there were other stylistic strings to Ungerer's bow, and the ads and posters he created at this time revealed a flair for cut-out shapes and collage. Nevertheless, it was undoubtedly his book work which occupied the bulk of his time, and in 1961 The Three Robbers was published, and it quickly became his most successful to date. It was the first of his authored and illustrated works to be printed in full colour, and he combined flat and more overtly painted areas throughout this engrossing narrative, alongside the dominance of solid black in both characters and background elements. The result was a significant creative success, and it remains a timeless but modernist classic of children's literature. In 1964, another children's book, Flat Stanley, written by Jeff Brown, was published, and this cheerfully absurd and endearing tale was greatly enhanced by Ungerer's simple but expressive line drawing. In 1964, a collection of more adult-themed drawings was published in his underground sketchbook, and although not overly contentious, this book was certainly an outlet for his more sardonic humour, which was also evident in his visually eloquent poster for Stanley Kubrick's darkest satire, Dr. Strangelove. But the brightly coloured, roughly rendered series of posters he produced for the New York Times not much later were considerably more good-natured and agreeably surreal. 1966 saw similarly disparate work being published, with two books for children and one which was certainly not. His own highly imaginative and occasionally melancholic story, Moon Man, contained a series of colourful, absorbing illustrations. And so did his highly amusing collaboration with the writer André Hodier on the cheerfully absurd crocodile story, Warwick's Three Bottles. But he also self-published The Party, a scathing series of merciless and occasionally disturbing satirical drawings of the New York elite, executed with the same jagged linear attack as his earlier underground sketchbook. 1967 saw the publication of yet another solo outing by Ungerer, with the engaging Grimm's-inspired Zerelda's Ogre, which was by no means his only published work of that year. He also illustrated Mr. Tall and Mr. Small by Barbara Brenner, a story about a competitive giraffe and mouse living in the jungle. And if that wasn't enough, Ungerer also published his illustrated edition of the nonsense rhymes of Edward Lear, first published in the 19th century. By which point, even putting aside his other magazine and advertising commitments, this brought him to a total of around a dozen books in a three-year period, several of which he also wrote. At this time, his increasingly dissident political stance led him to create quite a few overtly propagandist posters, lamenting American involvement in Vietnam in particular. They were, of course, highly popular with the USA's disaffected youth, but considerably less so with their parents. But there was no denying they made their point with considerable impact and graphic eloquence. But alongside these angry political statements, he carried on with less controversial images, such as the bold, graphically simple illustrations for his picture book Ask Me a Question, also published in 1968. And he was creating less confrontational, brightly coloured absurdist posters for the Village Voice, with similar wit to his earlier New York Times campaign, and other more mainstream clients such as Air India. In 1968, he designed a poster for the film Monterey Pop, and his scribbled posters for the New York nightclub The Electric Circus weren't exactly mainstream in their appeal, but they were cheerfully risque. In 1969, a rewrite of The Sorcerer's Apprentice by Barbara Hazen featured a collection of bright pen and wash fantasy illustrations of considerable charm, and scenes of appropriate chaos and visual narrative engagement. But 1969 also saw the publication of the sexually explicit and some said perverted Fornicon, which involved rather preposterous S&M themed imagery, much to the disgust and shock of many. Even so, a year later he returned to considerably less contentious work for his authored and illustrated children's book The Hat. But the persistence of his perverse and subversive side inevitably had a negative impact on his status as children's author. In his own words, he had become a pestiferous outcast, politically, technically, erotically incorrect. He and his wife relocated to a farm in Nova Scotia, Canada, and two of his more entertaining books were published in 1971. I Am Papa Snap and These Are My Favourite No Such Stories was a collection of absurd tales which featured anthropomorphic animals in any number of surreal narratives. And the images he produced for this volume were a triumph of simple but effective humorous visual communication. I don't know how well it performed financially, but creatively it was an enormous success. And in the same year there was The Beast of Monsieur Racine, which although equally absurd, also had a strong emotional dimension about a lonely man, a strange beast he encounters stealing pears from his tree, and the relationship they form as the narrative unfolds. No Kiss for Mother, a tale about cats in 1973, was a successful stylistic diversion for Ungerer, in that it was created entirely in monochrome and exclusively rendered in graphite rather than his usual pen and wash. The story Allumette in 1974 saw a return to his more expected loose colour wash styling for another sensitively told and rather melancholy tale. In the same year, his collection of illustrations for the Tales of the Brothers Grimm were published, and the innate affinity for the cheerfully sinister so frequently seen in his own children's work was well to the fore here too, which made this a particularly successful and highly engaging interpretation of these centuries-old Germanic folk tales. In 1975, he illustrated Das große Liederbuch, a collection of popular German songs which sold well over a million copies, in no small part due to the many engrossing and amusing colour images Ungerer produced for the book. Following its publication, he and his wife relocated to Cork in Ireland, and he took an extended sabbatical from both writing and illustrating children's books, and focused instead on books for adults. Among them was the frequently surreal, satirical work about the human condition, Babylon, published in 1979. In 1981, an exhibition at the Musée des Arts Décoratifs in Paris celebrated 25 years of Ungerer's career. It was immensely popular and moved to various other European locations. The last of these was the Royal Festival Hall in London, where one third of the show was closed down, having met with strong objections from feminists about the sexual content on show. The Schwartz book was published in 1982, and its dark content recalled some of the scathing political poster work of the later 60s. And although not overly popular with the public, it was highly regarded by critics. The Joy of Frogs, an obtuse but engagingly comical satire on the book The Joy of Sex, was published in 1985. And a year later, with human carnality on his mind, he authored and illustrated a collection of more serious-minded drawings of the dominatrix prostitutes of Hamburg's red light districts, titled The Guardian Angels of Hell. By this point, Ungerer had become extremely diverse in the projects he got involved with, and in 1988 he even designed the Janus Aqueduct in Strasbourg, celebrating 2,000 years of the city's existence. Ungerer finally made a belated return to children's books with his illustrated edition of Joanne Spiri's Heidi in 1997. And a year later he wrote and illustrated a story about a young pug called Flix, which enjoyed considerable worldwide success. And by this point he had also become increasingly involved with humanitarian causes, working with the French Red Cross and Amnesty International, among others. In 1999, the book Otto, the autobiography of a teddy bear, was published, and despite the cosy and innocent-sounding title, this was actually a book which used the horrors of World War II as a backdrop, and contained some fairly graphic images for young readers, even though the message was obviously intended to be positive. In that year, Ungerer completed another architectural project, in the form of a kindergarten in the city of Karlsruhe, and being Ungerer, he created it in the shape of a comical cat. Le Nuage Bleu, a children's story with a strong ecological slant, was published in 2000, and an animated version was produced in the following year. 2 years later, his enduring perverse streak had another airing in the book Erotoscope, a collection of his more adult drawings culled from various points in his career. But this aspect of his work didn't prevent him from receiving numerous awards, and he was even named Ambassador for Childhood and Education by the Council of Europe. The Tomi Ungerer Museum opened in Strasbourg in 2007, and in that year his whimsical design for public toilets in the German town of Plockingen was also declared open. It was also the year that the animated version of The Three Robbers was released in France and Germany, and it was a rare example of an animation which did the original book visual justice. In the 21st century, and by this point well into his 70s, Ungerer worked increasingly as an artist, creating photographic collages sold as limited edition prints, and making quite a large volume of quirky humorous sculptures from found objects and scrap. Fog Island was his last children's book, published in 2013, and the mysterious tone of the narrative was captured very successfully in Ungerer's desaturated and occasionally sinister watercolours. And following an exceptionally long, creative and prolific career, the occasionally perverse and subversive Tomi Ungerer died in 2019 in Cork, aged 87.